Hello friends, welcome back to another video. So in today's video I'm going to show you how I created this acrylic extension using glitter acrylic. So before we start, please don't forget to hit that subscribe button and the bell icon to get notified about all my new videos. So let's begin. The very first step to any nail extension is to prep your natural nails. So today, as part of my preparation work, I'm using a cuticle remover to remove all the dead skins around my cuticle area. I will be using a wooden cuticle pusher to remove the dead skins. Once you have removed all the dead skins, you can just wipe the excess using a cotton dipped in alcohol, or you can just use a normal cotton to wipe all the excess, and you can then wash your hands. Next step is to push back our cuticle. So I'm using this cuticle pusher to push back my cuticle area. Next, I'm going to use this drill bit to remove any remaining dead skin around my cuticle area. So it's very important to remove all the dead skins from the cuticle area. The reason, if there is dead skin, then it may release oil into your extension, and then you may end up getting a lift at the cuticle area of your extension. So ensure that your preparation is perfect so that your extension lasts for like a month or two. Now next is, I'm using this soft buffer just to buff off the shine from my natural nails. Again, I'm not going any rough, I'm just gently removing all the shine from the nail surface. That's it. Once you're done removing the excess shine from the natural nails, you can just wipe off the dust using a cotton dipped in the rubbing alcohol or acetone. And after that, we are going to apply a dehydrator. I am using Mia Secrets dehydrator, and apply a thin layer. And as you can see on the screen, the moment you apply the dehydrator, it evaporates. So apply the dehydrator, and after that, our next step is to apply a primer. So this is a non-acidic primer from Mia Secret, and this also works as an adhesive between your natural nail and the extension. So always apply a primer. Now let's pour the acrylic liquid into the container. So today I'm using Mia Secret liquid monomer. I'm also using a dropper to pick the monomer from the bottle into the container. Next step is to prepping the brush. So I have Modelon's number 8 Kolinsky brush, and I am using it for the first time. So I'm just going to dip the brush into the monomer, and I'm ensuring that all the air bubbles are released. And once your nail brush is ready, then you can start with your acrylic extension. So today I'm using Modelon's glitter acrylic, and Modelon's clear acrylic, and Glam and Glitz cover beige acrylic powder. So I'm using 3 different acrylic powders to create this extension. Now it's time for the extension. For that we need nail foams. I'm using this foam, and before you apply the foam, you have to prep the foam. So there is a detailed video about the preparation of the nail foam, prep of the brush, everything, and I will put the link in the description box and somewhere on the screen so that you guys can check that video out. Now after prepping the foam, you can place the foam under your nails just like I'm showing on the screen. Now the foam is in place. As you can see, it's very well aligned with the natural nails. Now it's time for the acrylic application. So since we are using the glitter acrylic, so I'm going to give it a base using the clear acrylic powder. So I am just picking a small bead, and then I'm going to place it at the tip of my nails, and I'm going to define the length that I wanted to. I am also going to define the shape I wanted to. So I'll be creating a coffin shape nail, and I'm ensuring that my acrylic is placed correctly, and I'm also ensuring that I'm getting the right length that I wanted to. And after that we will be starting with the glitter placement. Now that I'm happy with the placement of the clear acrylic, and I'm also happy with the length that I wanted to create, now it's time for the glitter acrylic application. So I picked up a medium size glitter bead and I placed it exactly on top of the clear extension that I just created, and then I am gently moving it, and I am dragging it to the length that I wanted, and I'm ensuring that the shape is also coming together. While doing the glitter application, ensure that you have the opacity there, and if you have missed any places, just go back and pick tiny beads and then just cover wherever you wanted to cover. Also, if you notice where the extension starts, I have thin layers. I am ensuring that I'm only leaving thin layer of glitter acrylic there because I wanted to cover it with the cover base that I have showed you in the beginning. So just keep on layering it, and once you are satisfied with the glitter placement, then I am just encapsulating the glitter with the clear acrylic again. So actually we have a base of clear acrylic, then we have the layer of glitter acrylic, and on top of that we are again placing the clear acrylic just to encapsulate the glitter. Next is to create the transition. So I am doing it for the first time, so I won't say that my transition is very beautiful, but I managed to get it like pretty decent. So what I did is I placed a small bead not towards the cuticle area, but almost like left like 3 hairline gap, and then I placed it. I'm just dragging it on top of the glitter extension that I created. So this way we will be creating the transition, and I hope after doing a couple of glitter extension I should be able to get that perfect looking transition area. Once done, then we can just start working on the cuticle area. I placed another small bead and I'm just gently pushing the powder towards the cuticle area. I'm only going to leave one a small hairline gap between the cuticle area and the extension, and after that I'm just ensuring that the acrylic is smooth. And our extension is ready. Now the next step is to filing and prepping. So I removed the foams from the nails. I forgot to record that part, and now our job is to file it and shape it. So I'm using this hand filer, and I'm just giving it a rough shape on the sidewalls and on the tip of the nails, and after that I'll be using the e-file to do the rest of the filing. A small pro tip for the e-filing. So as you can see, I'm using my middle finger of the right hand to support the finger where I'm doing the filing. So as you can see, my finger always touches the nail that I'm doing the e-filing. This way I can ensure that the e-file is under my control and I'm not hurting myself or the client. And after that I'm doing the tip filing using the e-file. If you do the hand filing, it will take so much time to file down the length of the extension. So it's always easy to use the e-file to, you know, remove the length of your extension. In case if you guys wanted to see how to shape your nails using an e-file, please do let me know in the comment section. I'll be happy to make a video on that. Now that the filing is done, next step is to smoothen it out a little. So I'm using this soft file just to smoothen the top, the surface of the nail. Now that we have managed to even the shape of the extension, the surface is almost uniform. Next is to use this soft buffer. In case if we left any unevenness, you can use this buffer to file it off and make it all even. And after that, I will be using the other side of the file to bring out the shine. Once you're happy with the filing, then you can just wipe the dust off using a cotton dipped in rubbing alcohol. And after that, this is the fun part. All you have to do is just apply a top coat, gel top coat. I'm using Model 1's gel top coat, and this will bring out the shine of the glitter that we placed under the clear acrylic, and this way the nails will come into life, and this is the final look. And I hope you guys enjoy this video. This was one of the first trial, and as you know, I'm no expert. I learned it all from YouTube, and I also attend webinars and I follow a lot of channels. That's how I learned the extension, so I thought I will share some tips and tricks with you guys, and you can also see my journey. So that is the intention. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please don't forget to like, share, comment, all those good things, and I'll see you soon on my next video. Stay happy. Thank you.